In every magazine you find ads, lots of ads. Some ads stand out and some don't. It's the same way with entrepreneurs. What makes some stand out while others are ignored? More and more you're seeing ads like you see in magazines turn up on Facebook. We've long ago shifted from a text-based internet to a visual-based internet. When we advertise now, we truly are side-by-side with the most famous brands in the world. Considering that, how can we stand out? Have you ever had the feeling when you walked into a room that all eyes are on you? That your presence alone created a seismic shift in the energy of the room, causing everyone to pause for a moment and look to observe what had just shifted their attention?
Hello everyone, I'm Marshall Wayne, and what you see here is, well, what I do. I create captivating ads that go to a sales funnel that leads you here. I realized initially that this page and video were so over the top that it would be nice to balance it with me just sitting in my place here in Los Angeles. So that way you could see, well, you can see part of where I think up my words and create my images and videos all right here. I didn't want you to think it was anything overly fancy. Now, I'd like you to think for a second about what brought you here and caused you to want to listen to what I have to say. For instance, what is that energy that draws you in? Or for that matter, since we're in Los Angeles, what is it that makes a movie star a movie star? What is it about them? Or for instance, or a president, presidential, or an icon, iconic. It's been called charisma, presence, the it factor, je ne sais quoi, and many other labels throughout history. So in the next few minutes, pay close attention to the words you hear, the imagery you see, and the imagery that surrounds this video. I designed it to put you into a state where you can imagine what it will be like when you learn to create a presence that holds a captive audience. After all, when you upload a video, make a post, or place an ad online, it's essentially the same as walking into a crowded room. Except this room is very, very crowded. You want to be that person with the ad that stands out. You're here watching me now because you saw an ad of mine that caught your attention. Think again about what made you respond. What feeling did that ad give you? Why did it lead you here? Those questions are important. Asking those questions allows you to reverse engineer what I did to get you here. However, you won't have to do that. I will show you. Now, true to my nature of enjoying cinematic elements, I initially considered many styles of videos to put you into that desired state. Maybe a movie trailer style intro.
There are many who strive, and of those who remain, there is only one who can truly be called a hero.
Or maybe a darker style Quentin Tarantino look. Or more likely, now that I designed a futuristic feel for this page, I'd even do a futuristic look with a holographic iPhone.
Walk away. This is yours.
Or maybe I'd even clone myself. Instead of doing all that, though, I want to show you what really creates that magnetic presence. It does involve imagery. Great imagery and great video helps. However, it only helps if you're able to tell the right story. If you don't have a compelling story, images and videos will simply magnify a story that people aren't interested in. You may feel that you don't have an interesting story. However, the public is able to be engaged on a level beyond the flash that you're used to seeing if they have a sentimental bond with the product or the person. The most important idea in advertising is new. People like new things, new songs, new movies, new products, new services. Knowledge is easily looked up, so people aren't often compelled by facts. What you have that is unique only to you and that is completely new to the prospect is your life, your story. There is also a deeper bond with the prospect, nostalgia. Learning to shape your life into a compelling story with words, imagery, and video creates a nostalgic bond with the prospect. They've often been where you are. They relate to genuine human stories on a deep level. Learn to tell your story with vivid, specific details that people can relate to. For instance, I write my emails and Facebook status updates in a highly personal manner. My main business, where I perfected the art of branding myself, is as an international currency dealer. Recently, I wrote a post about that business that sparked a great deal of response on my personal page. I'll read it to you here. At 26 years old, I sat in Kenosha, Wisconsin, waiting for the FBI agent to arrive. He said he'd be there at 9 a.m. He was, exactly. That was a scary morning for me. Since I had recently begun importing Iraqi dinar into the U.S., I didn't yet know if what I was doing was legal. I sell Iraqi dinar, the Iraqi currency, to investors who are hopeful that its massively depressed value due to the war will increase as commerce takes hold, their oil and natural gas reserves are more fully tapped, etc. I had considered my exits from the condo in case it wasn't legal. That's true. It was my repeated $20,000 wire transfers to a bank in Amman, Jordan that tipped them off that something may be amiss. Fortunately, after an hour of him sheepishly scanning the room, analyzing my book collection, observing my personal mannerisms, and asking questions to learn exactly what I was doing, he determined I was within the law, U.S. law anyway, and it turned into a recruiting session. However, I had other plans than to work for the FBI. Big plans. He did suggest, and I agreed, that since my business is Iraqi currency, an easy target for terrorist money laundering, that I run any suspicious activity through the CIA's Iraqi rewards program. My roommate, immediately after the agent left, said, "Mar, that was the coolest fucking thing I've ever seen." That's a true and very raw story about my life. Writing emails or status updates like that allow people to peer into our lives, and it creates that sense of nostalgia within them. As I was building my brand and my currency business, I continually received offers from other entrepreneurs for them to hire me to help them with their branding. It wasn't until I came across an article in the New York Times that I became fascinated enough to want to do so. Here is how it came about.
3 years ago, I came across a paragraph, buried 5 pages into an article about a professional athlete, that changed the way I thought about creating the ultimate entrepreneur. The journalist was able to visit the agency that represents the world-famous athlete. He said this, "When I visited the New York offices, an entire room was dedicated to building the brand of this athlete. Whiteboards were covered with lists, apparently resulting from brainstorming sessions discussing the mythology and iconography of this athlete. A wall was covered with a collage of the athlete's photos and quotes. Part of the strategy," a senior vice president in charge of this athlete's account said, "is to play up the rivalry between his clients and his main rival." He compared it with epic generation-defining rivalries like those between Sampras and Agassi, Palmer and Nicholas, and Magic and Bird. Such matchups not only provide great theater, it turns out. Managed and publicized properly, the senior vice president explained, they also move product. I couldn't get it out of my mind. I read that paragraph over and over. That day changed the way I did everything in my business. I searched for everything I could find about this agency. And even though it is the biggest agency of its kind in the world, representing athletes like Tiger Woods, Maria Sharapova, and many of the biggest names in the fashion world, all I could initially find out is that it's a highly proprietary methodology that they put their clients through. I became obsessed. It was quickly obvious to me that Hollywood must have an even more elaborate star-creating method at their disposal. They did, big time. I learned it piece by piece. I created this persona of the movie star entrepreneur and made a fan page and blog with that name. I did so because it would then give me an excuse to create images and videos that were cinematic in nature without having to explain why I was doing so. "It's to build my brand," was all I'd say. Since every place I looked into was highly secretive about their process, I decided to begin reverse engineering their branding and marketing campaigns. Initially, I used a flip cam and a camera phone. This made me much better than I would have otherwise been. I couldn't rely on a fancy camera and Photoshop or video editing skills. I had to learn to tell a story by creating images and videos with the equipment I had. I was figuring it out piece by piece. I started creating pieces that emulated anything the fashion designer Tom Ford was doing. I started with one piece and learned to reverse engineer it. I'd photograph myself in the same way as the model. I'd then put it into Photoshop and look up tutorials on how to color it in the same manner as I saw in the ad. Naturally, initially they didn't look very good, but I continued reverse engineering images and videos until it became second nature. I started to feel like I was peering into a secret world that wasn't meant to be seen. Friends and business colleagues began asking what I was doing. Images and video are only one piece of the puzzle. Learning to monetize came next. In phase 2, I began reverse engineering their marketing campaigns, to learn how they were using the eyeballs generated with the captivating images and videos and turning them into money. At the time, Facebook's ad platform was well underway, and more serendipitously, the fan page tabs were almost exactly like a format you'd see from an ad in a magazine. I created a tab and PDF named Style. I modeled it entirely on what you'd see for a fashion ad in a GQ magazine. Here's a snippet below of how it looks. My name is Marshall Wayne, and before I show you how to brand yourself online with GQ style photos, I'm going to take you on a trip. We'll head up Highway 5, north of San Diego, where you'll be in my neighborhood. Here, you'll find two utterly distinct towns, La Jolla and Pacific Beach. If Beverly Hills is the playground of famous movie stars, then La Jolla is the playground of jet-setting billionaires and young internet entrepreneurs showing off their exotic cars. You see women with million-dollar pieces of jewelry casually eating lunch on the outside patios of eclectic restaurants, and headstrong homeless preachers dotting the beautiful coastal landscape.
God said I give you ears to hear!
And then there's Pacific Beach. I live in Pacific Beach, the less fashionable of the two, though this is a superficial tag to express the bizarre and not a little sinister contrast between them. Here, the weeknights are much like the weekends. During the week, this town is already all ahoot with fun seekers, drinkers and surfers screaming in the alleys, and dopers out on food errands. You'll enter a local bar at 4 in the afternoon and be greeted with the sounds of All Along the Watchtower by Jimi Hendrix blaring on the jukebox, with locals well into their daily drunk. Fear and loathing in Pacific Beach. They say the night belongs to the poets and madmen. You'll find that in Pacific Beach. Both towns give you the feeling that you're in a movie. It's magical. Nothing seems quite real. Everything operates in a way much different than the everyday world. Being a creative type, I draw energy from this contrast between billionaires and hippies, drug seekers and deity worshippers. In both my real world and my online world, I try to find that thing, that magic, that you often only find in movies. It's been called charisma, the it factor, je ne sais quoi, and many other labels throughout the ages. As I walk through these two towns, I notice people who exude that magic, and businesses who attempt to make their customers feel that magic. It's been a quest of mine to bottle that magic and replicate it online in my business. I spend my days wondering how I can create a magical aura around myself and my business. I'm fascinated by books and movies because they allow a behind-the-scenes look inside the world of great minds and great lives. I attempt to replicate portions of those lives into my world, as I'm doing right now with this video, with you now watching me through my window. Let's cut the film look off, cut the music, and have you come inside.
Now that you're inside my rather meager office space, bedroom, I want to show you how to create your own personal style online.
It wasn't meant to directly monetize. It was meant for me to be able to test ads with imagery that hadn't been seen on a self-employed entrepreneur level, and then send those eyeballs to a video and PDF that also hadn't been seen before on this level. Here is a bit of the Style PDF.
Hello. My name is Marshall Wayne, and welcome to Style. I'm a firm believer in style, in design. Fashion fades, only style remains the same.
$53.5 billion, $53 billion for Bill Gates, and Warren Buffett's at $47 billion. Not too shabby.
Let me tell you, Rihanna's song, you make me feel like I'm the only girl in the world. It's a song about a girl.
Sir, suit activated. Systems check. We are now online. Sir, a client just contacted us and is wondering how to set up a blog. Do you have any suggestions on what I may be able to tell this client?
Command Central, you have an urgent call from Special Assistant of Operations. Please respond. Command Central, you have an urgent call from Special Assistant of Operations. Please respond.
It created a wave of responses that I had hoped for but didn't quite anticipate. Countless messages came in using words like genius, stylish, charismatic, magnetic, elegant, all words that I had intended to convey. Even though it was meant as a testing of branding principles, it brought me a wave of clients, a huge wave. Overwhelmingly, the response was, "Marshall, I want what you did there. Do what you did there for me. I don't care what it costs." If you're thinking that thought right now, there are two ways for you to get involved with me. You may hire me, fly me to your location. I'll bring all of my equipment, my fancy cameras and lighting setups, my green screen and editing software. We'll shoot every photo and video you need for everything from branding purposes to ads that'll drive prospects to your landing pages and sales pages, and we'll develop it all right on site. When I leave, you'll already have a fully professionally designed ad and sales funnel, much like you see here and on my style tab. I put my clients through a crash course, much like the one that I read about in the New York Times, so that I can create a captivating presence around them. However, that'll run you between $5,000 to $25,000, depending on how much time you need. And the other way to work with me is to become part of my Icon engineering system. Much, much less expensive, but you'll still get to work with me one-on-one. You've been through my sales funnel and you're watching this video at the moment, so you're already aware of what I do. Again, think of what has led you here, and you'll know exactly what I'm going to teach you in the system.
I decided to come back on camera to explain the details of the program to you. When I'm offering a product or service to someone, I like to do it in a highly personal fashion. I like you to be able to look me in the eye while I show you what I'm offering, and you may then determine if what I have is worth the investment. I'm looking to build a tribe of people who want to become the grandest version of the greatest vision they've ever had of themselves. That is what my Icon Engineering program is designed to do. It's structured around what I've personally done myself. There is no theory. So you'll see me referencing things that I've already done, not what I've seen someone else do. The program will run you through everything I reverse engineered from the article. It'll run for 6 weeks and have 6 modules, with the addition of a pre-module and bonus modules. To describe it in the simplest form, I'm going to teach you how to become every character on Mad Men. You're going to be the ad man, the account man, the creative, the copywriter, the model, and the actor. In the pre-module, the pre-module is called What You See Is What You Get. Frankly, the most popular request I get is that people want to learn how I put together what you're seeing here. From the ads that led you here, to this page, to the video you're now reading, along with all the effects in the video. You'll have access to those videos first. These will be some of the more difficult items you'll learn in the Icon Engineering program. But if you master these things, you'll already be where you need to be. It's designed to satiate your curiosity, and show you what you will learn by the time you're finished. Module 1 is titled Becoming Your Brand. When I first started my quest to learn how to engineer an icon, I took out a notepad and at the top I wrote, Becoming Marshall Wayne. That was powerful. It helped me realize that my development was in my hands. It wasn't the responsibility of some Hollywood agency or a government or military agency to see that I became the ideal version of myself. It was in my hands. I'm going to show you how to find the brand that you want to be, and then to fit your reality to that brand. Recently, when I spoke at Yannick Silver's Underground event in DC, I took this photo that you see here and posted it with the caption, "How will they see me?" You can also see it here on the 20-foot screens when it became part of the speech. It attracted a large response because we are all keenly aware of who we wish we were and continually wonder how we can give that impression to others. One of the first photos I'm going to ask you to take of yourself that will stay private to you is a photo like this. You'll have in writing, "Becoming You," with you being your name. And with it will be a photo of you looking at the person you want to become, your future self. You're going to enjoy this module. I can't wait to share it with you and see you develop. Now, module 2 is titled Becoming Camera Ready. Whether you've been on camera for a while or you've never filmed yourself, I'm going to show you the setups I use, how I make myself comfortable on camera, what I wear depending on the video, my lighting, my backdrops, and the cameras I use. I'm going to show you 5 images that you can take that will increase what I call your captivation quotient, and 5 videos that will increase your captivation quotient. And these can all be done on an iPhone or any camera phone. Module 3 is titled How to Create a Captivating Facebook Presence. Whenever I do interviews, I often hear that I get the most engagement on my post that anyone the interviewer has ever seen. Now, there is a specific reason for that, and I'll show you the formula that I use to write my status updates that capture the minds of my audience and how I get them to respond in any way that I'm looking to get them to respond, whether it's click a link, buy a product, watch a video, vote on a cause, etc. I'll also show you how I put together imagery using what I call digital fashion. Now, digital fashion isn't for everyone. It's just something I made up. But if you embrace it, you'll be light years ahead of your competition. I'm not going to go into detail on it here. Some of you know what it is and some of you don't. You'll learn about it. A main component of this module is creating Facebook tabs. You'll see how I created my style tab. You've probably seen the normal internet marketing style tabs. They're built that way because, frankly, the people don't have the skills to build it any other way. You are here to be better than that. I'll show you how I did everything from the imagery to the video and effects in the video on that style tab. I'll show you how to require people to like your page before they can see your content, and I'll show you how to create an opt-in form right there on the Facebook tab. And I'll show you how to create a PDF filled with HD video and high-end images that will serve as your personal manifesto that will be freely given out to promote your brand. Module 4 is called Facebook Ad Mastery. How to create Facebook ads that look like they came from Madison Avenue. Placing an ad on Facebook is easy. It's a matter of pushing buttons and entering targeted pages whose fans you want to reach. What isn't easy is creating an ad that attracts attention. We'll go through the basics here. I'll teach you how to target a specific audience at the lowest price. However, you aren't here to learn what you can learn in a $47 ebook. You're here to become your ideal self. I'll show you how to get inspiration from the biggest brands in the world to create ads that get attention. If you see what a billion-dollar brand does, you can be sure they've spent millions making sure that ad attracts clients. By reverse engineering what they've done, you can create a million-dollar ad without the budget. This is the most important part of my business. Building a brand means nothing if it doesn't bring in money. Module 5 is titled How to Get National Publicity on YouTube. At 26 years old, one of the worst videos I ever did on YouTube got the attention of a reporter from the Baltimore Sun-Times who interviewed me about my currency business. That article was seen by CNN, Wired Magazine, and the USA Today. The USA Today put me on the front page of their money section. That then led to the LA Times, New York Times, and CNBC, all from one YouTube video that I'm embarrassed to show. I will show you that video and describe to you how to parlay one video into one interview that leads to more and more interviews. Not only that, but 3 of my YouTube videos have had my voice extracted from them and used in songs. The first was by multi-platinum selling rapper Soulja Boy for his song, Getting Paid.
$53.5 billion, $53 billion for Bill Gates, and Warren Buffett's at $47 billion. Not too shabby.
Cheers.
I get to travel in that world quite often, and it's interesting, especially being an entrepreneur.
Sliding through the city in that purple thing. Soulja Boy, tell him, you know I'ma make it rain. Nigga, I'm the shit. Nigga, I'm the truth, man. Word around town. Soulja got the juice, man.
The second was by I Am Breed, titled I'm That Man.
constantly working while you're doing other things. Things you call living your life. You always knew there was always a figment of your imagination that knew that there was someone out there.
Third by Hetke Beats, titled Hometown.
Hey everyone, I'm sitting here with Paul Hetke. We just got done with a pretty easy run. This is the round of play.
Let's get it. Yeah. Around my hometown.
I'll show you how this happened, although I don't yet know if it can be replicated. It may just be a stroke of dumb luck, but I'll show you how it happened nonetheless, and we'll see what you can make of it. Module 6 is titled, How to Become the Biggest Star on Earth. Although the title of this module is as hyperbolic as they come, this is the module where, if you want, you'll be able to learn how Hollywood, political, and titans of industry are branded and promoted. This is my favorite module because I pull no punches. There's a very good chance it'll be outside the range of what most people feel they are capable of doing. However, a few of you, those with the biggest dreams and the grandest talents and creative energies, will find your true self here. This is where you'll learn to shine bigger than you ever have. My bonus module is just titled Fun. Frankly, much of what gets me the biggest response is when I post images or videos that are purely for fun. Your fan base and potential clients want to see the real you. When you're having fun, you are being the real you. If you want to learn how to do a holographic iPhone video, put yourself on the cover of a magazine, or on the red carpet with a few celebrities, or any other fun pursuit, I'll show you how it's done. Now, I'm looking to build a tribe of creative, uncompromising misfits who are looking to build their ideal brand. If you're one of these people and you like what you've seen here on this video, please join me. The payment and entrance details are below. And thank you for watching.